Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text 34 to 36, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in July of 1966 in New York.
What is that subject matter?
Knowledge.
Tadviddhi panipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadakshanti te jnanam jnanina tatta darshan. For knowledge, we have got to go to the right person, tatta darshan. Tatta darshan means one who has actually seen or experienced the Absolute Truth. So, unless we find out such a person who has actually seen the Absolute Truth or who has in his experience what is Absolute Truth, there is very little chance of our spiritual advancement. If we can find out such a person who is experiencing absolute truth, and if we follow the principles as it is stated here, pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. Pranipat means to surrender, and pariprasna means to inquire, and seva means service. Three things. You should find out a person who is self-realized, who has experience in the Absolute Truth, and on your part, you have to surrender there, and you have to inquire, and you have to render service. When these things are completed, there is no doubt about one's spiritual salvation. If you have actually found out a person who is self-realized and who we have surrendered there, honestly, with inquiry and service, then we must know that our spiritual salvation is guaranteed. Guarantee, there is no doubt about it. So, Lord Krishna says, yad gyatva na punar moha evam jasasi pandava yena bhutani aseshena drakshasi atmani atha mai. People are anxious to see God. Here, Lord Sri Krishna says that as soon as one gets knowledge from the right person, then he never comes into the field of delusion. The whole thing is that in the present stage of our life, we are conditioned and deluded. We do not know things as they are. That is the cause of our all misery. Otherwise, constitutionally, we are anandamaya bhyasat. By nature, we are jolly. Anandamaya bhyasat. In the Vedanta Sutra, you find the nature of Brahma is anandamaya, sachidananda vigraha, Ishvara parama krishna sachidananda vigraha, sat chit ananda. Sat means eternity, chit means full knowledge, and ananda means pleasure. This is our constitution. We are all fragmental portion of Krishna, the Supreme Lord. Therefore, because He is Anandamaya, Satchidananda Vigraha, so we are also Anandamaya, Satchidananda Vigraha. Unfortunately, we have been put in the context of this material energy. Therefore, we are just experiencing the opposite. What is that opposite? That Sat-chit-sat-chit-ananda. Sat means eternity. So, we have got just the opposite, asat. Asat means non-eternity. This body will not exist. We are put into such a condition that however scientifically we may try to keep an youthfulness by so many medicines, injections and so many things which are invented by our advanced material science. But death is sure. The body, antavattini deha, the body must be finished. Therefore, there is no question of sat. And chit, chit means knowledge. Knowledge, we have no knowledge. We have got senses, but these are all imperfect senses. We are very much proud that everything we say, somebody tweeted about the Lord. We challenge, can you show me the Lord? Have you seen the Lord? Or can you show me the Lord? But you do not know that our senses are so imperfect that we cannot see even what we are daily seeing. We cannot, if the light is put off, then we cannot see each other, even in this room. So our seeing power is conditioned. It is not perfect. Similarly, all our senses, they are imperfect. So, by imperfect senses, by speculation of imperfect mind, we cannot reach to the absolute truth. It is not possible. It is not possible. Therefore, here it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita that tad-viddhi pranipātena. If you are at all serious to understand the transcendental knowledge, then you must approach the person who has experience of the Absolute Truth. Otherwise it is not possible. If you think that I shall realize by mental speculation the Absolute Truth, it is not possible because you are you are fortified with only imperfect senses. Your senses cannot approach. Therefore, Brahma is said, abhāga-manasa-gocara, abhāga-manasa-gocara. It is beyond the mental speculation. And there is another name of the Supreme Lord, adhokṣaja, adhokṣaja. Adhokṣaja means adhākṣita-ākhaya-jñānam-yatra. Where our material senses are defeated. Our material senses are defeated. We are defeated in every respect. So it is not possible to realize the absolute truth if we do not find a person who realized soul, who is absolute, who has understood. It doesn't matter who is he. Lord Chaitanya recommended just like in India, generally the Brahmins are expected to be the spiritual master. Because Brahmin means who have sufficient knowledge in the transcendental science. That is Brahmin. Brahma-jānāti iti Brahmin. Now, due to this modern age, Kali Yuga, it is very difficult to find out a qualified Brahmin. So therefore, it is very difficult also to find out a qualified spiritual master. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has recommended that Kiva Sudra, Kiva Vipra, Nashikane Noa, Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sai Guruha. Never mind whether he is a Brahmin or a Sudra or a Sannyasi or a householder. Never mind what he is. That doesn't matter. If he knows the science of Krishna, then he is the bona fide spiritual master. He is the bona fide spiritual master. So here, this Bhagavad Gita is the science of Krishna. Every one of you, if you study Bhagavad Gita very scrutinizingly, with all your arguments, with all your sense, with all your philosophical knowledge, because it is said here, Tadvibhi pranipatena pariprasnena. Not that you have to submit yourself blindly, although your spiritual master may be self-realized and experience is the absolute truth, still you have to question, you have to understand from him all critical points by your intelligent question. That is a law. So, it doesn't matter if anyone is able to answer about the science of Krishna, he is spiritual master. He is spiritual master. It doesn't matter where he is born or what he is, whether he is a Brahmin or a Sudra or an American or an Indian or whatever he is. Never mind. Just like it is practical. When you go to a doctor, medical practitioner, you do not ask, well, doctor, are you American, are you Indian, are you Brahmin, are you Jew, are you Christian? No. Oh, he has got the qualification of a medical man, so you surrender. Doctor, treat me, I am suffering. So there is no question. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given liberal that anyone who knows the spiritual science, the Krishna science is spiritual science. Because Krishna is the ultimate goal of spiritual science. When I speak of Krishna, you must remember that I am speaking of God. There are millions of names of God in different parts of the world. But Krishna is the supreme name according to Vedic knowledge. So therefore, Lord Chaitanya has recommended, and his recommendation is accepted by the authorities even at the present moment. Kiva Sudra, Kiva Vipra, Nashikane Noy, Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sai Guruha. And you will be surprised that Lord Chaitanya's principal disciples were all so-called fallen in the society. He appointed one Haridas Thakur, Namacharya Haridas Thakur. This Haridas Thakur was a Mohammedan. He happened to take his birth in a Mohammedan family. But he became a follower of Chaitanya. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after training him, he gave him the highest post of his spiritual mission. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared to introduce this system of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, and chanting of the holy name of God. And he appointed this Haridas Thakur, who happened to be a Mohammedan, but he became so much enlightened that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appointed him the supreme minister of administering this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. He was made the authority, Namacharya. Acharya means the prime minister, the authority. So, there are other six important and direct disciples, just like Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami. Now, these These gentlemen were formerly known as Sakar Mallik and Davir Khan. Davir Khan, that was the Mohammedan period. India was being governed by that time by the Pathans. And in Bengal, there was a Pathan ruler whose name was Nawab Hussain Shah. But these gentlemen, Sakar Mallik and Davir Khan, they were appointed minister in the service, on the governmental service, Nawab Hussain Shah. And in those days, the Hindus are so strict that anyone accepting the service, especially the Brahmin, if a Brahmin accepts the service of anyone, especially who is not a Hindu, he is at once extricated from the society. So these two gentlemen, Sakar Mallik, they changed their name also. They were actually Brahmin, very intelligent, learned, they are very good scholar in Persian language and Sanskrit language, they are very good scholars. But because they engaged themselves in the service of the Mohammedan ruler, or they were, extricated from the society, Brahmin society. So Chaitanya, they also followed Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and they were made the best authorities in the science of Krishna science. They later on they became the Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami. So there is no bar for anyone that one cannot become the spiritual master. Everyone can become spiritual master, provided he knows the science of Krishna. That is the only quality. That is a very reasonable. If you do not know the subject matter, how can you be a teacher? A teacher means he knows the things, he knows the science. The only qualification of the spiritual master, as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Kiva Shudra Kiva Vipra Nasitane Noy, Jai Krishna Tattvavetta. Anyone who knows the science of Krishna, this is science of Krishna, this is Bhagavad Gita. If anyone knows perfectly, then he becomes the spiritual master. And there is need of spiritual master at the present moment. We require thousands of spiritual masters to preach all over the world the science of Krishna. The science of Krishna. That will solve all problems of the world. Take it from me. We discuss amongst our confidential devotees here, and they agree that actually this is the science which can mitigate all the problems of the world. So, jadgyastam punar moham evam jastati. So, Krishna says to Arjuna, he's addressing Arjuna because Arjuna is here as representative of us. He was not speaking to Arjuna alone, but he was speaking to all the human race. So, jadgyastana punar moham, by understanding this science, then you cannot be illusioned, because Arjuna was illusioned and he was not prepared to fight. So this instruction was given, this Bhagavad Gita instruction was given to Arjuna. So he says that if you have actually undergone the training under the experienced bona fide spiritual master, then you would not have gone under such illusory energy. Jena bhutani ateshana drakshasyam. Then again he says, api chedasi papibhya sarvebhya papakrittama sarvam jnana plavenaiva vrijinam santarishyasi. Now, Lord Sri Krishna says that just like if you have got a very good ship, you can very easily cross the Atlantic Ocean without any difficulty. Similarly, we are in the midst of the ocean of ignorance. Our this life, this conditioned life, in the material world is just like the ocean of ignorance. Ocean of ignorance. So, Lord Chaitanya, therefore, he prayed to Sri Krishna like this. Ai nanda tanuja patitam kintaranamam bhisame bhavam budho. My dear Lord Krishna, I am just fallen in the ocean of ignorance. So, we are in the ocean of ignorance. Now, in the ocean, if you get a very good boat, a very good ship, as you can cross over. Similarly, if we have the ship or the boat of perfect knowledge, then there is no fear. We can cross the ocean very easily. We can cross the ocean very easily. Now, here Krishna says, apitedasi papibha sarvibha papakrittam. If a person is the most sinful, they are the supermost sinful man, but if he gets this knowledge of Krishna's hand, then he can cross over this ocean of ignorance very easily. That means it does not matter what was our past life. Either any Vedic literature, especially Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita does not take into account what was you in the past life. That doesn't matter. Because we are in ignorance, we might have done so many things in ignorance which is not approved, which is not virtuous. That is quite possible. Every one of us, we are subject. Because due to ignorance we do so many things. So nobody can say that I am free from any sinful activity. Nobody can. So that doesn't matter. But if we can learn the science of Krishna, then Lord Sri Krishna said, api chedasi papibha sarvibha papakrittama. Even one is the most sinful man, but if he gets the Krishna's hand, he is free.